Hi folks, this video is a little experiment for me. It's my first video in English, all my other videos are in German. I hope my English is good enough for you to understand me. When I recorded the video, I didn't have the idea to make an English version as well, so I recorded the English soundtrack afterwards. That's why my mouth movements don't match the sound here. This will not happen in future videos. From now on, I will try to make all videos in English too, but I can't promise if I'll do that with every video. That's enough for the foreword, I think. Let's go to the actual content of this video. Today I would like to show you how I try to make something productive on my self-made milling machine. I have to finish these parts for a friend. He's already done the first side. Almost 80 pieces are to be made. So I thought about it, how I can mill it productively. Since the parts are already finished on one side, I decided to make a soft jaw. I was thinking of making 3 to 4 places for the parts. The width of the vise would have been enough. But since the hexagon is not milled so precisely, I had to worry that the parts will hold properly if I clamp more than 2 at the same time. With 2 of them, I can be sure I won't get into any trouble. The movable jaw of the vise will tilt, so both parts will get about the same damping pressure. The soft jaw itself is nothing special. I have simply milled in the negative shape of the part to be clamped. I drilled holes back here to clear the corners, then the holes for the screw and the soft jaw is finished. The parts I mill do not have to be manufactured so precisely, that's why I have no doubts that everything will work with this soft jaw. You should also be able to produce very precise parts with it when you need it. The origin of the soft jaw is in the front corner. I just touch it with the 3D probe. The position of the 2 parts is therefore precisely defined. The soft jaw and the parts to be milled were modeled together in the CAD, so it was easy to create the milling operation in the CAM. I already milled the soft jaw in a previous video. This is in German. However, I will show you a card to the video if you want to see how the soft jaw is milled. Now some information about the milling process. Here you can see the finished part, how it looks at the end. And here's the starting part just like I got it. I have to remove the base and mill this cross here. This is a special tool for an Audi. I don't know exactly what this is needed for, but the tool is not normally available for sale. That's why you have to make it yourself when you need it. I have optimized the geometry of the cross a little bit. The tool is used to open a screw that has such a cross shape. First I removed all the material in the middle. I changed that. I just mill a little deeper into the corner so the tool fits into the screw. That saved me about 30 seconds of milling time. I've gone from 4 minutes to 3 minutes 30 seconds milling time for 2 parts now. With 80 parts, you are finished much faster than before. I have to use a 3mm end mill for the corners. Therefore, I mill the clamping base and the cross completely with a 3mm end mill. I was thinking about roughly removing the material with a larger end mill, but I would have lost the time I would have saved by the additional tool change. That's why I thought I'd make the part completely with the 3mm cutter. Then I don't need the extra tool change, which could easily take longer because I insert the tool manually. And so I have also time to clean and pack the finished parts while milling the other parts. And of course, milling the chamfer just with a chamfer end mill. With the cutting data for the 3mm end mill, I was a bit too fast when I milled the first parts. As you can see, there's not much left of the end mill. After 8 parts, the end mill broke off. I then adjusted the milling data a little. I have slightly reduced the step over and the feed per tooth, but I increased the cutting speed. As a result, the feed rate is even slightly higher than before. That's why I haven't lost any time with the new cutting data. However, this should reduce the force on the cutter. I'm curious if this will work out better now. I hope that this will work, because I don't want to change the end mill every 8 parts. Now I want to show you short how the clamping works. Just put in the parts, close the vise, put a little pressure on the top of the parts when you close the vise. It don't has to be too precisely here. Short test if the parts are fixed, and then you can start the milling process. I think that is everything I can say about this. If you have any questions, just write them in the comments. Now I will show you the milling process of 2 pieces without any video cutting, so you can see exactly how long it took. And after that, I will be here again and give you a short conclusion of the milling of the parts. As you can see, everything worked quite well. I'm really happy about the new cutting data. The end mill hold over the remaining parts really well. It is dull now, but I think that's okay, because the end mill removed quite a lot of material. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up. I also would appreciate a subscription. And I hope my English was good enough so you can enjoyable listen to that video. And we will see us in the next video. Goodbye.